The year of 2017 has been one of significant change and upheaval for South Australia. ABC News broke the story of abuse at the Oakda aged care facility in Adelaide's northeast, followed by revelations of mistreatment and cover-ups in the state government-run institution. There were all the machinations of state politics, from Nick Xenophon's planned re-entry to state parliament, to the opening of the new Royal Adelaide Hospital and subsequent resignation of former Health Minister Jack Snelling. Take a look back at some of the other big stories of the year. In March, Tesla boss Elon Musk made an intriguing wager on Twitter with Australian entrepreneur Mike Cannon Brooks. He said his company would install one of the world's largest batteries in South Australia, which was still reeling from 2016's statewide blackout. Tesla will get the system installed and working 100 days from contract signature or it is free. That's serious enough for you. He tweeted. Mr. Musk visited Adelaide in July and put pen to paper, choosing to build the 100-megawatt system next to the Horsdale Wind Farm near Jamestown in the Mid-North. But he did have to worry about footing the bill because the battery was completed on time and South Australian taxpayers chipped in $50 million. Also in March, South Australia Premier Wetherill awkwardly confronted Federal Energy Minister Josh Frydenberg in a press conference over the Commonwealth's repeated criticism of the state government's handling of its electricity supply. The Holden plant at Elizabeth closed during October, ending decades of car manufacturing in both Adelaide and interstate. There was delight in Huila as a British entrepreneur stepped in to buy the city's Arrium Steelworks with plans to transform the facility and secure its future. Mystery surrounded Chinese mining magnate Sally Zhu, who regularly takes out full-page ads in the local paper, including one where she sought a large home for her family in South Australia. And construction of the Darlington upgrade in Adelaide's south this year included a delicate operation to move a 3,000-ton bridge into place. Some of the state's most viewed stories this year came from its busy court system. A Queensland woman was sentenced for murdering her elderly grandfather in Adelaide's south after claiming she was motivated by a horror television series. An Adelaide couple were jailed for kidnapping and torturing their babysitter in an 18-hour ordeal. The South Australia coroner started investigating the death of an Adelaide woman who had been taking up to 800 laxatives a day. Federal court proceedings were launched against Heinz after a product for toddlers, marketed for its fruit and vegetable content, was found to contain large amounts of sugar. And in a Colombian court, York Peninsula woman Cassie Sainsbury was sentenced to 6 years in prison for trafficking cocaine. She was caught at Bogota's El Dorado International Airport in April trying to smuggle 5.8 kilograms of cocaine inside 18 separate packages of headphones. Adelaide Crows women's team captain Erin Phillips and coach Beck Goddard led the team to the inaugural AFL Women's Premiership in March. The men's side went on to reach the AFL Grand Final for the first time in almost 20 years.